So I think I have the privilege of one of the best jobs today. Right? So Sheikh talked a lot about some of the very visible activities that we do as the Indian Society. However, one of the things that is particularly apt in this season of giving, right? You know, sometimes, you know, you look at all the ads and you look at Black Friday and you look at the, you know, Christmas specials and you forget that this is really a season for giving and sharing. And one of the things that makes me incredibly proud to be a part of this wonderful organization is a lot of the giving work that we do. And so today, we are very proud to recognize our ISW Crisis Committee. So I'm going to invite up on stage some of the members who are here. So Mr. Raju Anand, who's the chair. Mrs. Usha Verma, who is the past chair for many years and also a current member. John G. Anand is here, he's one of the members. And Mr. Shyam Sharma is our founder, and he has been our guiding spirit for the last 55 years. And one of our newer traditions with this ISW Christmas program is many of the families who are in the audience today actually make contribution towards the ISW Crisis Committee. And so to hand over the gift from the community to the ISW Crisis Committee, I'm going to invite Mr. Elisha Tandikonda. Oh, and Mushaji reminds me, I don't see Carolyn. Carolyn Passy is in the back. She's also a member of the ISW Crisis Committee and also the founding chair of the ISW Culture Center. So come on, Carolyn. Karen, please come and join us. First of all, of course, I want to say a big thank you to Mr. Gula and the entire group here because you have been most supportive to our crisis committee for the last so many years. And I can vouch to you today that 100% of all your contributions goes to families and children who are in dire crisis need. So every penny or whatever you give to our organization goes towards helping someone in crisis. I'm also glad, first of all, I want to recognize Mr. Shyam Sharma here, who is the first chairman of our and founding member of the crisis group. And we also have the youngest crisis committee member, John Gianna, who was recognized this year for his contributions to volunteer activity for domestic violence by the society, by YWCA, and they gave him an award called the Great Guy Award, which is given once a year. So the Great Guy Award usually is awarded either to the mayor or the police chief, to the other commissioners, health commissioners. For the first time, they recognize a person from our community and for the work that we do in domestic violence. So I want to thank all of you for the support that you have given us. And I just want to tell you that we would love to have more volunteers. Our volunteer needs right now is to provide assistance to families and children, provide transportation, and to provide emergency financial cash. So these are our main needs. Our cards are outside at the desk, and you know, you can always contact us through our ISWO online website, and we are available 24 hours, 7 days a week, and you will find Usha always promoting our crisis group in all the organized activities that happen in the Indian community. All I can say is that we do not wish crisis to happen to anyone. It is a time for giving and love. Christmas is the time for giving and love, and we want to make sure that those who are not able to enjoy the kind of things that we can, we should take the opportunity to provide and help them. And like Dr. Irikula mentioned today, that the purpose of life, really for all of us who come here and want to have settled down, is our children. And mainly, we do every act that we do for the higher being. And today, Jesus Christ was brought to our minds in a big way. I remember the day when I had the opportunity to kiss the hand of Pope Pius in my school in Bombay, when the Pope came to India for the first time. And there are lots of inspirations that we can take away. Christ's committee is committed to helping every family in our region, and we do not discriminate. We have terrific partnerships and networks with several organizations. We can help anybody in need, whatever be your crisis. Our definition of crisis is your definition of crisis. If you think you have a crisis, whether it is small or big, or whether it has to do with your child, or your family, or your job, or your financial situation, we will do our best to provide you with the right kind of people so that you will be helped to overcome the crisis. And that is what we like to do. So I could talk about several stories that we come across in crisis. You know, I can tell you some. Initially, when we started crisis, we were only dealing with people who had a death in the family. Now we are dealing with every situation of life, of living here in the U.S., with children and with women, and especially with domestic violence. And we have established network partnership with the government, with the governor, the lieutenant governor, the representative that came to the Hannah game, and our selectmen in town. And we have connections with all the business folks to provide financial help and job opportunities and training. We have connections with government and police departments to make sure that if anybody has any legal problems, we can take care of it. The district attorney is connected close to us, the police chief is connected close to us, and even DCF, Department of Child Welfare, is connected very close to us. As an example, we have our traditions where, we raise children the way we were raised in India, and sometimes it can cause problems. As an example, I can mention that there was a child who was going to be taken away by DCF because they thought there was child neglect because the mother was giving the same food every day to the child. And children, for example, they have set clothes. Monday you wear this, Tuesday you wear this, Wednesday you wear this. And the same clothes are being put to the child, and they think the child is being neglected. So there are many instances where you can come across a crisis situation. Crisis committee, we have a lot of members, we have a lot of associate members. We can help in every situation. So if you know anyone in crisis, don't let the crisis get worse. Try to stop it before it can develop into something that cannot be handled. Lastly, I just want to let you know that we lost 19 people who were killed due to domestic violence. Domestic violence in this country is defined differently. In India, domestic violence is to be defined as physical violence. In this country, if you do not provide freedom for your spouse, for your partner, intimate partner, to express themselves in daily life, she can complain to the police that she's being domestically violated. So the definition of domestic violence is simply a feeling of fear from one of the intimate partners to the police. That's all it takes. And also, we have a lot of connections with legal lawyers And with the court system, I remember, you know, most of our committee members spend approximately 200 to 300 hours a year. And it takes approximately 2 years to help a person to settle down. And a lot of this time is spent in the court system. We have lawyers. Lawyers are very expensive. But we have lawyers who will do pro bono work. We have family lawyers. We have immigration lawyers. And we also have lawyers that deal with domestic violence issues. So please use India Society. India Society is committed for this activity. And I want to thank our president for helping us promote this and keeping it alive every day. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Raju. And can I invite Mr. Hari Konda to present the gift on behalf of the community?
I would like to say thank you to the Christian Society, part of the US Society, for donating. We are so generous giving this money. I tell you that this money is for worthy cause. It helps the children and women who are living a lot of difficulties here. So thank you all for the donation.
Today, you are celebrating Christmas. And I am very happy, but you should know the history of India. And I am asking you, be proud that you are Indian and say it with joy that I come from India. Why? Because India is the only country which gave the shelter to everybody who came from outside. Christianity came to India before it came to Europe. Jewish came to India. Long ago, Parsis came to India, even what you call these Armenians, they came to India. Why? Because India is a country which gives shelter to anybody without any question. Jews were not allowed to own land in Europe. And India said, yes, come, be farmer. Europe, they didn't allow. They lived in the, what you call the wagons. And the Armenians, the Jews, they came. I don't know how many you know where they live in India. Calcutta is the place where Armenians were very large number of population. And the Parsis, Tatars, they said thank you because you gave us shelter and the Iran threw us out. So please be proud. And America's freedom is also has a part of India. Why and how the first shipment of tea came from India in Boston. They people used to unload it. And the freedom started because instead of unloading, they threw the baskets in the water. And that's part of the freedom of America. Thank you, all of you.
This one too. Let all of you know that this very year, 2017, we have helped over 300 families and 200 children. So 100% of what you are giving is going to go to these people. There are people in need right now, and it doesn't stop. So if you like to volunteer, please call and come and join us and be part of the team. I can tell you one thing, if you do, any good deed for somebody else, it provides happiness for yourself. So in the spirit of Christmas, I want to wish everybody happy Christmas and many new years.
Let's put our hands together for I.S. Heavenly Christ and some good deed. I know it's probably very loud, it's very late. I know everyone is hungry. The last item we have now is the cake cutting. I would request President Mr. Ashish Kaulagi and his wife Aarti Kaulagi to come and cut the cake. But this is the first family of ISW, and he is the youngest president at ISW. So let's put our hands together and invite the couple to cut the cake. Merry Christmas, they said. Alright, so we're gonna sing Merry Christmas song and then that's it. Alright? So you wanna join? That way you'll be more hungry and then we'll enjoy the dinner that is provided by two families. They have lovingly cooked at home. So this is home cooked food that we're gonna eat. So, you know, it only hikes up the appetite. So the